So today we'll start our lecture on acid, bases and salts. So first of all, let's do what is an acid and what is a base. As we have already studied that an acid is defined as, what we have studied in lower classes, an acid is defined as a substance which are sour in taste. Acids are defined as those substances which are sour in taste. And what are bases? Bases are those substances which are bitter in taste. Plus, bases are soapy to touch. One very important property of bases is they are soapy to touch. Soapy to touch means you feel as if a soap is being rubbed on your hand when you touch a base. So, bases are bitter in taste, bases are soapy to touch, and acids are sour in taste. These points you might have studied in your lower classes also. Now there is one more word in this chapter, salts. What are actually salts? Salts are formed by combination of two or more compounds. Salts are formed by combination of two or more compounds. What does this mean? This means that when two or more than two compounds react together, then the substance formed is known as a salt. Let's take an example. For example, when you mix NaOH with HCl, what you will get? You will get NaCl plus water. Now this NaCl formed in this reaction is known as salt. So salts are those compounds which are formed by combination of two compounds which have properties different from these two compounds but will be formed by combination of two compounds. Now in this chapter, the first topic that we need to study in detail is an indicator. What do you mean by an indicator? Now, as the word itself indicates, indicator is defined as any substance which identifies the nature of other substance. Any substance which identifies the nature of other substance or which indicates about the nature of other substance. So indicators are those chemical compounds, indicators are those substances which identifies the nature of the other substance. Now indicators are divided into three categories. First one is natural indicator, second one is artificial or more precisely synthetic indicators. Artificial or synthetic indicators. And the third one is olfactory indicators. This olfactory indicator topic is being asked in the board exam this session only for 3 marks. So we'll do all these 3 topics one by one. Now let's come to the natural indicators. What are natural indicators? So as the word itself dictates you, natural indicators are those indicators which are obtained from natural substances. Those substances which are found in nature. For example, what are the example of natural indicators? That one is litmus, that you have studied in 8th and 9th class, and that second one is turmeric. First one is litmus and second one is turmeric. Now in this topic, what will be the type of question which will be asked in your exam? In natural indicators, the first topic will be the definition of natural indicators and second one will be the color of these natural indicators in different types of substances. So let's come to the color of these indicators. So first indicator that we'll take is litmus. Now what is litmus? How it is prepared? Litmus is a type of purple solution. It's a type of purple solution which is obtained from lichens. Now what are lichens? As you can see in your book, there is one paragraph at the end of the page. Here it's given in detail. Litmus solution is a purple dye. It's a purple solution which is extracted from lichen. Extracted means which is prepared from lichen. And what is lichen? It's a plant belonging to the division Thallophyta. It's lichen is obtained from a plant which is belonging to Thallophyte subdivision of plants. And this litmus is used as an indicator. Now, this we have studied that litmus is obtained from lichens and lichen is a plant. Then now, what is actually lichen? It's not given in a book, but we'll do in detail. What is actually lichen? Lichen is defined as a symbiotic association. Lichen is defined as a symbiotic association. What is symbiotic association? Symbiotic association involves two components which are living with each other, and which are working for each other. There are two components, two partners which live together, which functions separately, but both of them are benefited from each other. Like in lichens, the two components are algae and fungi. The two components are algae and fungi. Means one type of algae and one type of fungus when living together, then they are known as lichens. The fungi uses the food which is synthesized by the algae. Since algae is having the chlorophyll components in it, therefore it will synthesize the food, and that synthesized food will be utilized by the fungus. When this fungus will utilize the synthesized food, it will break it into small components. Those small components will be used by algae to again synthesize the food material. So both of them are benefiting from each other and living together. Therefore, it is a symbiotic relationship and it is known as lichens. So we have studied litmus is obtained from lichens, and lichen is a symbiotic association of algae and fungi. Now we were discussing about the color of the indicator that we are using. So first we are discussing about the color of litmus solution. As you have studied in lower classes that litmus is available in two types. We have litmus solution also, and we have litmus paper also. Originally the litmus paper is, or the litmus solution is of purple color. When we are obtaining the litmus solution in industry, it is of purple color. It is of violet color or purple color. When this litmus solution is changed into paper, then it comes into two types. One is blue litmus paper and second one is red litmus paper. So we have two types of litmus solutions, blue litmus solution, red litmus solution. We have two types of litmus papers, blue litmus paper and red litmus paper. Now let's come to the color. When we are using litmus paper in acid, when we are using litmus paper for an acid, then the blue color litmus paper will change into red color. The blue color litmus paper will change into red color when the substance is acid. And if the substance is a base, the substance which you are testing is a base, then the red litmus paper will change into blue. What does this mean? This means that the colors will change in acid and base. How this is going to happen? Suppose this is a strip of red litmus paper and you are having a substance A with you. Now you want to identify the nature of this substance A, whether it is acidic or it is basic. So you take a drop of A and pour it on the red litmus paper. Pour a drop of A on the red litmus paper. If this red litmus paper changes to blue, that portion of red litmus paper on which you have poured the substance A, if that portion changes into blue, then the A substance is basic in nature. But suppose this color is not showing any change, no change in the red color. So the substance is not basic in nature. It may be acidic, it may be neutral, but it is not basic in nature. So first we have done for basic nature. How you will confirm the basic nature? If the red litmus paper is changing into blue litmus paper, then the given substance is basic. But if the red litmus paper is not showing any change in its color, then the given substance is not basic. This is sure that it is not basic. It may be acidic, it may be neutral, but it is not basic. That we can assure that the given substance A is not basic. Now let's come to the acidic nature. Now suppose you have another strip of blue litmus paper. This time we have a strip of blue litmus paper and you are given a substance B. Now identify the nature of substance B. Again repeat the same step. Take the substance B, pour a drop of B on the blue litmus paper. If that region on which the substance B is poured, if that region of blue litmus paper changes into red color, if the portion of blue litmus paper changes into red color, then the given substance B is acidic in nature. 100% assured that it is acidic in nature. But if the red color is not changed, if the blue color is not changed into red, no change in the blue color of litmus paper is observed, then the given substance is not acidic in nature. We can assure that the given substance is not acidic in nature. It may be basic, it may be neutral, but it is not acidic in nature. So what we have explained? We have explained that if the blue color litmus paper changes into red, then the substance is acidic in nature. This observation indicates that the substance you are using is acidic in nature. But if the red color is changing into blue, then this indicates that the given substance is basic in nature. Now what about neutral? We have identified the acidic nature, we have identified the basic nature. What about neutral? The neutral substance will show no change on the blue litmus paper, no change on the red litmus paper. If the blue litmus paper is also not changing and the red litmus paper is also not changing, it means that the given substance is neutral in nature. It is neither acidic nor basic. So we have completed the color of litmus solution in acidic, basic and neutral substances. Now let's come to the second natural indicator that we have discussed. That one was turmeric. Second natural indicator is turmeric. Now the original color, turmeric, I hope all of you know, it is known as haldi in Hindi. Say Hindi mein haldi kehte hain. So the original color of turmeric is yellow. Originally it is of yellow color. When this turmeric is spotted on the cloth, when we put turmeric on a piece of cloth, that piece of cloth will change into yellow color. Now if we add an acid to this yellow color, suppose we are taking lemon. If you take lemon juice and pour this lemon juice on this yellow spot, what you will observe? No change.
The yellow color will not change. It will remain as yellow. It means that the substance that you have added to the yellow spot is acidic or neutral in nature. Turmeric is originally yellow in color. In acidic medium, it does not changes its color. It shows no change in the yellow color. It remains yellow only. Now, let's come to the basic color. Again, we take that piece of cloth. It is having yellow color of turmeric. And you might have observed in your houses that when we add a soap to this yellow color, हम जब खाना खाते हैं तो we have a spot of that food. We are using turmeric in our vegetables, in our food preparation. When we have yellow spots due to our food on the clothes, and when you wash that cloth with yellow spot, what you observe, that yellow spot changes into reddish brown spot, red spot or reddish brown spot, reddish brown color. This change of yellow spot into reddish brown color indicates that soap is a basic substance. Soap is showing basic nature. So we can conclude that the turmeric changes its yellow color into reddish brown color when it comes in the contact of a base. Okay, now what about neutral? When you take yellow color turmeric, we have yellow color turmeric, and you add water into that turmeric. We have yellow turmeric, and if you add water into that, what do you observe? We observe a yellow solution. Previously it was yellow powder, now we are observing yellow solution. Now if you can see, the color is not changing. Previously it was yellow color, after addition it is also of yellow color. So no change in the color. It means that a neutral substance does not change the color of turmeric. So from these three observations, what we are concluding? We are concluding that turmeric can indicate, turmeric can identify only and only the basic nature of substances. Turmeric can identify only and only the basic nature of substances, because its color is changing only in the basic medium. The turmeric shows no change in acid. The turmeric shows no change in neutral substance. So it is not able to identify the acidic or neutral nature of a substance. It can identify only and only the basic nature of the substance. So with this we have completed what is the acid, what is base, what is salt, what are indicators. As you can see in your book also, 3-4 lines are given about the indicators. Litmus is a natural indicator, turmeric is another natural indicator, and have you noticed that a stain of curry on white cloth becomes reddish brown when soap, which is basic in nature, is scrubbed on it. That is, turmeric is changing into reddish brown color when it is rubbed with a soap which is basic in nature. Again, one more observation is given. It turns yellow again when the cloth is washed with a plenty of water. Means when it is coming in contact with water, that is a neutral substance, it is again regaining its yellow color. Okay, then we have two more indicators, methyl orange and phenolphthalein indicators. These are synthetic indicators that will complete in our next class. So thank you for today. We'll continue the topic in next.